The dot product, level 11. In this video, we will go over our final application of the dot product. We will learn how to find the work done by constant forces. When you hear the word work, you might think about your day job or the crazy amount of problems you need to work on for your multivariable calculus course. In both cases, the word work agrees with the everyday or common meaning. In this case, an activity that requires muscular or mental effort. In physics, work has a much more precise definition. One does work by exerting a force on an object, while that object moves from one place to another. In other words, it undergoes a displacement. With work defined this way, you do more work if the force is greater or if the displacement is greater. As a result, the definition of work is based on these observations. We define the work, W, done by a constant force, F, that points in the same direction as the displacement, D, of an object, as the product of the force and the displacement magnitude. With this definition, the work done on the object is greater if either the force F or the displacement D is greater. The SI unit of work is the joule, abbreviated with the letter J. Since we are multiplying a force measured in newtons and then multiplying by a distance measured in meters, it follows that 1 joule is equal to 1 newton times meter. In the US customary system, the unit of force is the pound force, and the unit of distance is the foot. So the unit of work is the foot-pound. We can convert from one system to another by using the following conversions. Now, how do we find the work done if the object is pushed with a constant force that is not pointing in the same direction as the displacement? In the case where a constant force acts at an angle theta to the displacement, d, we must break apart the constant force into components. One component will be parallel to the direction of displacement, and another component will be perpendicular to the direction of displacement. In this scenario, only the parallel component of the constant force is capable of moving the object. So we will calculate the work done by using this parallel component of the constant force and the magnitude of the displacement d. This expression is true as long as both the force and angle theta are constant during the displacement. Notice that this expression matches the form of the scalar product of two vectors. Hence, we can rewrite the work done as follows. This expression is used to calculate the work done by a constant force, constant angle, and straight line displacement. We can also use the less common projection form. In this expression, the work can be calculated by taking the magnitude of the projection of the constant force F onto the displacement vector D and multiply it by the magnitude of the displacement vector. Usually, the dot product form is more commonly used in most textbooks. Last thing to keep in mind is that work is a scalar quantity and not a vector, since the dot product produces a scalar. Alright, let's go over a couple of examples and illustrate how to find the work done by constant forces. An object is pulled 10 feet across a floor using a force of 85 pounds. The direction of the force is 60 degrees above the horizontal. Find the work done. Alright, let's first draw a diagram of the problem. We're asked to find the work done when an object is pulled by a constant force directed at an angle. So we go ahead and use the definition of work. In this case, the force dotted with the displacement. Now, there are two different ways to solve this problem, since the dot product has two forms, the component definition and the geometric definition. Let's solve this problem by using the geometric definition first. We can find the work done by simply multiplying the magnitude of the constant force, the magnitude of the displacement, and cosine of the angle between the force and displacement vector. We know that the magnitude of the force is equal to 85 pounds, and the magnitude of the displacement vector is equal to 10 feet. We also know that the angle between these two vectors is 60 degrees. Substituting these values and simplifying, we obtain the final answer equal to 425 foot-pound. An alternative way of finding the work done is by working with the component definition of the dot product. We can also write the force in component form as follows. Then, we simplify the expression. We then do the same for the displacement vector. In this case, we will only have one component, since it is moving across the floor. Then, we use the component form of the vectors, and find the dot product. Simplifying the expression, we obtain the same answer of 425 foot-pound. Notice that you have two methods to find the work done by a constant force. Depending on the circumstances, one method might be a lot easier to use. Alright, let's try the next example. Find the work done by a force of 20 pounds acting in the direction north 50 degrees west in moving an object 4 feet due west. Alright, similar to the previous example, let's draw a diagram to get a visual from which we can work with. Using the given bearing, the force faces in the following direction, and the displacement faces west. With this information, let's go ahead and use the definition of work and use the geometric definition of the dot product. The magnitude of the force is equal to 20 pounds, and the magnitude of the displacement is equal to 4 feet. Now, the angle in this example is not 50 degrees. Remember, the angle we need to be using is the angle between the force vector and the displacement vector. In this case, 40 degrees, and not 50 degrees. Simplifying the expression and rounding to the nearest degree, we obtain 61 foot-pound for the final answer. Alright, let's move along to the next example. A horizontal force of 25 pounds is exerted on a box as it's pushed up a ramp that is 10 feet long and inclined at an angle of 20 degrees above the horizontal. Find the work done on the box. Alright, here we have a box that is being pushed up a ramp, and the force is strictly horizontal. Let's draw a diagram illustrating this scenario. Once again, we use the definition of work and multiply the magnitude of the force, the magnitude of the displacement, and the cosine of the angle between the vectors together. Simplifying the expression and rounding to the nearest degree, we obtain 235 foot-pound as the final answer. Alright, let's go over the final example. A constant force F moves an object along a straight line from point A to point B. Find the work done if the distance is measured in meters and the magnitude of the force is measured in newtons. Alright, in this problem, we're given the force in component form, and we're given the initial and final point of the displacement vector. We are asked to find the work done to move the object from point A to point B. Alright, since we already have the force in component form, let's go ahead and find the displacement vector by using point A and point B. So, subtracting the coordinates of point B from point A, we obtain the following for the components of the displacement vector. Now we will use the component definition of the dot product to find the work done, since we are not provided with an angle between the force and displacement vectors. Computing the dot product and simplifying, we obtain 38 joules for the final answer. Keep in mind that you can find the work done in two distinct ways, by using the component definition or the geometric definition of the dot product. Alright, in our next video, we will go over various proofs that make use of the dot product.